ever have a son, I'll name it.
Run! Leg it!
Take it easy.
Thank you.
Hey there. Faster. Giddy up. How long are you gonna make me wait? That's enough of that.
Yeah! But boy, that was brickworks.
Run, leg it!
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock.
A son, I'll name him Gerlat.
Slow now.
Thank you.
Come on, Roach. You're gonna make me wait. Get him! Come on! Not your lucky day.
That's it, Roach.
Faster.
You ain't safe unless you got a Gabrielle. The auto-crank one-handed Gabrielle ensures you get the first shot and the last word.
Let me have a look at your stock.
Rats, why did he need them?
Bloody rodents? Better to...
Kira, what are you doing?
Geralt! You gave me quite a start.
But nay, the magi says bring me rats and healthy ones. Not something the cat dragged in.
This the lamp from the elf's hideout? And what's this about rats?
Nothing important. I'll explain later. Now, tell me, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Bet the old witch who lived here left you a bunch of interesting sundries.
She did indeed. I gather you'd like a look.
Very much so. Mentioned you wanted something from me.
I did, and still do. The cursed isle on Lake Windama, you've heard of it, I'm sure. The local peasants mumble incessantly about it, about the wraiths that haunt it. They claim none who go there return.
How'd it come to be cursed?
That's what I don't know. I must break this spell, yet I've been unable to identify its source.
You've gotta know something.
Scraps. The curse is somehow linked to the tower where Serard, the lord of these lands, took refuge when Nilfgaard invaded. Claims in the village are that peasants, desperate of hunger, sailed to Fyke Isle to beg for food. Met their end there. It was a massacre. So, will you please help me lift this curse? You're so good at these things.
All right, I'll help.
I knew you'd find it irresistible. Naturally, you'll need to sail to Fyke Isle.
Fine. What then?
Well, the spirits who wander the Isle, you must establish a rapport with them. Don't know how, but they could point us in the direction of the curse's source.
Think they'll be willing to chat?
Of course, provided you take my magic lamp with you. I shall let you keep it afterwards in appreciation. You'll find it quite useful, I'm sure.
How's the lamp actually work? I mean, do I just rub it, or do I have to do something, magical?
You needn't even rub. Just place it where you find bones and hear whispers. I suppose I should warn you. It might not be the most pleasant experience.
Figured as much. Tell you all about it later. Maybe skip the drastic bits.
You'll need to do neither. I'll give you a Xenovox. It's a bauble that will let us speak over some distance. You will tell me what you see, and I shall tell you what to do and look for.
I need to know anything else before I go?
No, that is all. Oh, go already. I can't wait to see what you discover on Phi Kyle. Just be sure to come and see me afterwards. And Geralt.
Hmm?
Thank you.
Almost there.
Splendid. I shall contact you again soon.
Wait. This Xenovox. Can I contact you with it, or is it one way?
One way only, I'm afraid. You'll have to trust my feminine intuition.
Your what?
My feminine intuition.
Wonderful.
What did you say? must be very careful.
Doesn't look like the work of necrophages.
Come on. Millie, we gotta flee. Quick now. Millie! Millie, what's with ye?
I don't know. So up. Burning. Ah.
What? No. No, stay back.
Don't leave me.
Where's that noble?
Lying here, quiet as a mouse, head split open like a rotted pumpkin. More like a peasant now, sloshing around in his own blood and shite. Be nothing noble about him.
Too quick a death they gave him. Should have been made to suffer.
He's not the end of it. Sons can suffer for him, and the daughter. To the top!
Folk. Doubt I'll ever understand them. Keeping rats in cages like rabbits.
Let them out, maybe? Like to die of hunger if we leave them there.
I'd sooner burn the vermin. Releasing them's not like to bring no good. Imagine the harm they'd do if they swam back to the village.
Swam? Rats? How do you figure they'd do that?
You needn't fret for them. Clever little bastards. Clever than you.
They seem sluggish to you. Got the mange, maybe? Oh, and that stench!
Don't start, Annabelle. Back to your craft. Always bending my ear about fool peasants. I'll not hear of them again. That simpleton turned your head, but one Graham hardly makes the rest courtly, one and all.
My lord, peasants. They're through the door in the tower.
The noble died a time ago. Who's that? Show yourself. Anyone there? Who are you?
Here that looks like a laboratory.
Then you've not reached the highest level. Look for a passage.
Someone dragged something across the floor. More dragged it from one wall to the other, repeatedly. Looks like a laboratory. Pretty well equipped, too. Experimenting on humans. Never would have gotten away with it if the Conclave were still in charge.
Why did you leave? You claimed to love me. I'm cold. Why has no one come for me? I cannot leave this place. I see no way out. Who are you? Do you seek to hurt me as well?
Don't be afraid. I want to lift the curse that grips this island. Door turned to tell me who you are. The other ghosts, they couldn't see me.
I'm special. Always was. The rare beauty. The Lord's daughter. These lands, as far as the eye can see, were ours. My family and I, we hid in the Mage's Tower to await the war's end, the end of hard times. It was not to be forever.
Tell me what happened here. Peasants sailed to the island to ask for food. Is that true?
No! They came to rob and kill! They thought us rich, believed we'd stowed ourselves away here to laugh at their misery. Yet we had little food as well. Too little to share with those who came. They slaughtered everyone. I heard my father cry out, but the mage told me not to reveal myself or let anyone in. He gave me a potion. If I was discovered, I was to drink it. He said everything would be all right.
What kind? kind of potion was it? Remember its smell, what it looked like?
I remember only that I feared to drink it.
Didn't trust the mage?
In the village, they claimed he meddled in disease. Not curing it, but causing it. They said he lured rats into the tower, infected them with the Catriona. Only rumors, surely, but I was afraid. So horribly afraid. And then I heard him. My beloved Graham. He called to me. I opened the door for him, but others rushed in. They lunged at me and...
Did they hurt you?
They gripped my arms, tore at my dress. I managed to free myself and drink the potion, and then... nothing.
Poisoned. That how you died?
No. For I later awoke. I was alone, it was dark. Only there were rats. Everywhere. Dozens. Hundreds. And I... couldn't move.
Sleeping potion. Effects hadn't worn off yet. You were paralyzed.
They were everywhere. All over me like insects. My face, my hands. I felt them rip open my skin, then crawl into my stomach. They tore me apart, and I could not even scream. Have I not suffered enough? Why can't I leave this place?
How can I help you?
A curse born of hatred binds me to this place. Only love's power can hope to lift it. But who could love a race?
And your beloved, he dead too?
Graham. No, he lives. I would know if he died. But he fled and abandoned me. Left me here all alone.
Maybe you could strip the curse of its power by forgiving him. You might cleanse the isle. As I see it, you're the curse's focus. The other ghosts on the island, their auras aren't nearly as strong as yours. My medallion started pulsating as soon as we started talking.
I don't know what you mean, but you do seem to know some things. You could be right. My fate is tied to the isle, I feel that. Perhaps because I am heiress of these lands.
It could be your blood ties to the land, the base of the curse, that is. If so, forgiving Graham, laying your resentment to rest, should lift it.
I loved him. I'm prepared to forgive him. But I must know that he regrets what he did. Take my bones to him. He must bury them. This will be our farewell. Will you speak to him? Will you do this for me?
Really sad story, but something's not right. Got a feeling.
What is it?
You're not telling me everything. You know the island's dangerous, but refuse to tell me about the monster that lives here.
There is no monster.
I think you're lying. Question is, why? To protect the beast? Or is it that...
Stop! I will not hear this!
I can't help you. Taking anything off this cursed island, from any cursed place, just too dangerous. And a dead woman's bones, that's asking for trouble.
They said witches are heartless beasts. Will you bring Graham here then? I so long to say goodbye.
Annabelle, listen.
You never wished to help me, and here I have someone who would finally take pity on me.
kill me.
You know this.
What's that? It sounded for a moment like you joined the raids yourself.
Had to fight a pester.
A pester? And did you learn how to lift the curve before you lunged at her sleeping hand?
Yeah, we talked a bit. Looks like I need to get her beloved to the island. Fisherman named Graham.
I know the man. He lives in Oriton, village on the lakeshore. Find him immediately. We're close to unraveling this. I can feel it.
I want to talk.
You deaf, damn it! I told you! Who are you?
I've been to the island. I know what happened there.
What do you want of me?
Want to talk to you about Annabelle.
Annabelle? What can you know about her?
I met her. Talk to her.
Annabelle's dead. Drank poison. And I couldn't save her.
What happened on Fike Isle? You gotta tell me.
'Twere Millie, Finch, and Faulkner. They rallied the men, all roughs, to go to the Isle, take back what was ours from the noble. They knew I was known at the tower, that the Lord's servants would open the gate for me since I sold them fish.
They force you to go with them?
No, I saw my chance in it. For Annabelle and me to flee. But it all spun into chaos. Our boys from the village, they started killing everyone. Annabelle, they wanted to rape! 'Twas then she drank the poison. Mage must have gave it her. I ran out the tower, hollering that I wanted to die, cursing them all to hell. Don't force me to speak of it. No more, please.
It wasn't poison. Annabelle drank a strong sleeping potion. Mage wanted to protect her, make it look like she was dead. Convinced everyone.
But that means... is she... you said you spoke to her?
Spoke to her ghost. By the time she awoke, tower was full of cold corpses. And rats. She was warm meat. Rats ate her alive.
She was alive the whole time? But... can't be. She was cold all through like a corpse. We shook her, begged her, open your eyes. I never thought...
Annabelle needs you. You can help her.
She's still there. In the tower. Can I see her?
Yeah. One thing you should know, though. In death, Annabelle turned into a pester.
A pester? What's that?
More than a restless ghost. A plague maiden. A powerful wraith filled with grief and hatred that drive her. Give her the power to sow disease and death.
She suffers. How am I to help her? Gods know I'm willing.
A curse has imprisoned Annabelle and the other spirits on the island. Love can shatter its power, free her and them.
Just as in the legends.
If you know the legends, you know one kiss is enough to break an evil spell. On one condition. That it's a kiss from someone whose love is true.
I told you. I said I love her with all my heart. Take me to her, please.
It's dangerous. There are risks involved. Understand that, don't you?
Of course. I'm no coward. I'll not run this time.
Nothing. Let's go.
I'm ready.
Let's go to the tower.
Impossible. We could have been together, and now she's dead. And it's my fault. If only I'd been able to protect her.
Can't change the past, but you can still help Annabelle to move on, to rest in peace.
I'd never have left you. I'd do anything for you. I would. You know that well. Believe me. I beg you.
Prove it. Kiss me.
Graham, careful.
At last.
The curse is lifted, and Graham and Annabelle are reunited.